I talked to a young college student yesterday who said that he felt that part of the problem is segregated schools, which you have here and everywhere else in this country. I mean, we thought the 1954 Brown decision was going to end that, and instead we have more segregation, as much at least as then. And he was saying that if young people are in separate schools, not getting to know each other at an early age, not getting their history at an early age, it leads often to hatreds and misunderstandings of the other. How do you fix that? You've got segregation right here in Charleston. How do you fix that?
Well, first of all, this guy wasn't in Charleston, and I know
you keep saying that. But he's from South Carolina.
But he's not from here. He's from 110 miles away.
But the point is, the schools are segregated.
Well, I mean, some are, but most of them are not. I mean, the progress that's been made on that is huge, and we don't know whether this guy went to a segregated school or not. Certainly, the more integrated our schools are, and the more we enhance our understanding of each other, it's why I've been working so hard to create the International African American Museum here, because Americans do not know African American history. We don't. We know a little civil rights history, but we don't know the whole story.
Why is that important?
Because we need to understand who we are as Americans, and it gives us a chance, white people, to better understand and respect the heritage of African Americans. And it's very important that we do, because, see, we were never taught that history in America. It's like blank chapters in a history book. And to understand who we are as a country, we need to understand where Africans came from, how they were captured, what cultures they represented, civilizations they represented, what life was here, the harshness of it, the struggle, and all steps to this current day.